We need more supply of houses, houses of every type, social homes, affordable homes, homes for people to purchase.
This is bad policy. We do not back bad policy.
If the Labor Party think we're just going to roll over, then they've got another thing coming.
Political squabbling leaving the Housing Australia Future Fund on shaky ground.
This is not tit for tat. People need roofs over their heads. Get on with it.
After a month-long standoff between the government and the Greens.
What sort of party are you?
It's crunch time for Labor's $10 billion plan to address the housing crisis.
If the Greens genuinely want more social and affordable housing in our communities, then it's time for them to vote for it.
What they want to do is invest that big chunk of money and use the earnings to build 30,000 social and affordable homes over 5 years. It's got the go-ahead in the lower house, but needs the Greens on side in the Senate. And until now, they said no deal, demanding $5 billion earmarked annually. But over the weekend, they shifted ground.
Let's be clear. We halved our offer from $5 billion a year for public and affordable housing to $2.5 billion. I would like to think that actually $2.5 billion is a relatively modest ask.
They also want an incentive for the states to freeze rent for 2 years. And on that one, they say they will not renege.
There are millions of renters across this country now who are paying more than 30% of their income on rent. We need to do something on rents because it's not sustainable to have unlimited rent increases for the next few years.
The bill is scheduled to hit the Senate again this sitting fortnight. So can the Greens and government find a common ground?
The only wreckers of the housing market and the housing crisis right now are the Labor Party.
But this can't go on forever. It's time to put the ambit claims and the political games behind us.
Or will the public pay the price of this political battle of wills?
I just really feel right now, if the Greens want to make a statement, go and make one, but don't make it over people's lives when they need a roof over their head, when they've got kids. Enough's enough.
Jackie Lambie seems to be speaking the most sense on this issue, right? I mean, how many stories have we done over the past 6 months on the current housing crisis?
One a week, at least.
At least. I'd say several a week. Yeah. And all we've got, all we've had from our elected officials, months and months of arguing, no real solutions. We still have families living in their cars. When Anthony Albanese became Prime Minister, I think a lot of people were excited by the fact that he'd been there. He knows what it's like to live in public housing. Mm-hmm. And the hold-up on this is just infuriating. Mm-hmm. No solutions. And you've also got a building industry that's collapsing. We've had like 1,700 builders collapse.
That's a big part of this story, which we're kind of overlooking. It's like, I think we can think they can magic up these houses if they just agree, but actually who's going to build them and how quickly can they build them anyway?
But that's the thing, but all of this hold-up, right, it just adds to that because it's like they're not going to build them even now. If they were like, green light, go tomorrow, you're still going to have so much delay.
Right, but so do you think this is just politicking then? Because I see this as a genuine disagreement about the policy.
Do you think
I don't
understand the absolute need for housing at the moment? Do you think they actually understand in Canberra what's going on? The politicians.
So you would put the Greens in the same category as
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, I would.
I just think that they disagree. Like, for the Greens, I can see their argument. They're going, you need how many billion dollars to do this? Put the money in now and start building them now. Mm-hmm. The government says it's a much more responsible thing to invest it and get the money later. Mm-hmm. I actually think they've both got reasonable positions here. Yeah. And so I get that it's frustrating for us. Yeah. But ultimately, this is what politics ends up being about, right? And it's a question of who
not
can ultimately... Well, yeah. I mean, yeah, I take that point. But you do want the policy to be right, don't you?
Yeah, I do, I do. I think it's just, it's really hard to tell people who don't have anywhere to live how to suck eggs.
I agree
because of what's going on in Canberra.
Obviously.
Yeah.